Hello and welcome to another one of my BTPs, Play the Police, and this go around I'm going to look at laying out and breaking down the police's beds too big without you. And great news on this, it's pretty straightforward, only four chords. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to play it around a couple of times, show you the chords, talk a little bit about the hook, and also if you're a beginner, go through a little bit about the kind of technique that you need in order to get this kind of clip staccato sort of reggae-ish sound, which again is indicative to this particular piece and also a lot of the police's earlier work. So as I say, let me just run through it and we'll break it down. There you have it. Couldn't be simpler. That's basically it. That repeats throughout the entirety of the song. So what I'll do now is I'll just quickly break down the chords and talk a little about this hook, again if you're a beginner and you're not kind of too sure what's going on there. So basically what you're doing, you're starting off with E7 at the 7th fret there, where you're barring at the 7th fret. Your second finger is on the B string at the 8th fret and your third finger is on the D string at the 9th fret. And what you're basically doing here with the synchronising with the down and the upstroke, you're hammering on and pulling off with both of these fingers, the second and third finger. And so if you're a beginner, it's actually might be just a good idea actually not even to worry about the right hand, just practice. It's kind of almost like you don't even really need the right hand, but obviously, you know, this is what it is. So you've got three downs and one up on that hammer and pull off. Then what you're doing is you're out of this shape. All you need to do for the next chord is to take your second finger away, just leaving the third there, and just move it down to the fifth fret for a D9 chord. And then you literally, for the next chord, the third chord, you just move that whole shape back up to the seventh fret for E9. Then the further progression is you just again keep the third finger there, move it up one fret to the ninth fret. The 8th fret, and then just drop your second finger back down onto the G string at the 9th there, as I say, and that's for F major 9. And then etc. Now, about this kind of clip staccato sort of flavour that you need to give this, as I say, if you're a beginner, and you're starting to get into it. I mean, obviously, you know, obviously to form chords, it's all about the hand pressure in terms of squeezing the strings down onto the frets or behind the frets and keeping that pressure on in order to sustain notes. And if you do that, the notes sustain and they travel. But with this particular kind of style, what you've got to do is, to say, you've got to cut that ringing dead. You've got to get that clip staccato sound. Now, you do that by basically, it's kind of like you've got to feel the rhythm in both hands, both in the left hand and the right hand, because what you're doing is, as soon as you put in either your downstroke or your upstroke, what you're doing is you're immediately releasing the pressure on the neck with the hand, the left hand, so that the strings are away from the fretboard, not on the fretboard, and your fingers are just gently laying over the top of them, hence it will dampen that ringing and, as I say, then cut it dead so you can get more of this. In my left hand there. Another good fail-safe backup device as well, particularly if you're playing, you have to play this kind of, or you're playing something really loud, and maybe sometimes you might get a little bit of buzzing because you're not moving it away quickly enough with this other, is to use this portion of the right hand down here. And again, as you put in your down or your upstroke, you basically follow through with this part of the hand and just slip it onto the strings down here, and consequently, obviously, that'll cut absolutely everything dead. So something like this. Now, in this little bit here, there's what happens here is in this bit. what you're doing again is you're synchronizing, squeezing on and lifting off in time with that up and down rhythm. And when you're doing your up and down across the strings when they're in their muted state, you'll get this kind of, I think what they call kind of a scratching, raking sound. So you're kind of, as I say, you're kind of squeezing on, squeezing off. So in this particular section, it's kind of on, off, off, on, off, off, upstroke, on. A little bit faster, it might be. Now, when you land on the D9 there, keep the pressure on, because if you listen on the record, he puts in that nice cheeky little slide back up into the E9. So, that's pretty much it. I think that's pretty much it.